Hey, Team FTD, hope you guys are doing awesome today. So I found this video about decoding the Illuminati and the power of triangles. I thought it looked pretty interesting. So let's watch it right now. I haven't watched it yet, so I'm gonna watch it the first time ever with you guys.
We call them chakras because they symbolize movement. So that orange triangle with the circle around it is the Agna chakra, which is the chakra of enlightenment and knowledge, and knowing and perception. Because yoga is the science of perception.
Whatever you are referring to as Illuminati, and later on it transformed itself into Freemasons, about the Baalbek temple in Lebanon, which is about 4,200 or 300 years old, where they built a Phoenician temple which was built, where Indian masons and Indian elephants worked, every Lebanese child knows about it in their school, but none of the Indians ever study this or anything like this is mentioned anywhere in any of the Indian history books, unfortunately.
And the first question is by Aniket Divadkar. He says, "Hi Guruji, in recent days I came across several contents about Illuminati, secret society, who are ruling our whole world using media, finance network and pharma politics. Even many leaders, gurujis and priests are under their control. Your answer on this.
not me.
But you have to still answer the question.
Yeah, I will, but I'm saying I'm not under that control.
I agree.
Okay, all right, let's get into it.
It is part of European culture to always, well, we are also imbibing it these days quite a bit. But in Europe, secret schools were romantic stuff. Even people who are now famous like a Socrates or Aristotle and these people, they were also part of the secret schools. Why would I make my school secret? Because society is in a mode of persecution of anything that it does not agree with. Persecution. Only if there is persecution, a school becomes a secret school, isn't it so? So secret school traditions are so much in Europe because the dogmatic religious beliefs were really suppressing anything that they think is gathering 10 people, they want to demolish it, they will kill them. So they ran secret schools. In this, whatever you are referring to as Illuminati, and later on it transformed itself into Freemasons, some history, I cannot confirm this, some books have been written as to how Freemasonry was started by the Indian Masons who went to Egypt. Because they had to survive in a strange land, they came up with all kinds of tricks how to survive. Among themselves, they developed code and communicated with each other in code language so that they survive in that hostile culture. And from there, it spread, that's what some books say, but there is no historical certainty about that. But it's possible, we know that stonemasons from India went for building the pyramids and the Baalbek temple. There are clear records about the Baalbek temple in Lebanon, which is about 4,200 or 300 years old, where they built a Phoenician temple which was built, where Indian masons and Indian elephants worked. Every Lebanese child knows about it in their school, but none of the Indians ever study this or anything like this is mentioned anywhere in any of the Indian history books, unfortunately.
Ancient architecture like this. Imagine what it looked like when it was complete in all of its glory.
So, later on it became Freemasonry, and Freemasonry took on a powerful form. When it went to United States, it took on a very powerful form. because the Christian dogmatic thing was so suppressive. Free-thinking people called themselves Freemasons, though they were not doing any masonry anymore. But you will see one thing, wherever Freemasons are there, the building designs are fantastic. I've gone to a whole lot of Freemason temples simply because I love the design part of what they have done, fantastic designs. Because geometry is very much a part of their culture. It is because of this probably somebody is writing books saying that they came from India, because in India the yogic culture invested itself absolutely in the geometric aspect of life. Yoga means in one way aligning your geometry so that you become aligned with the cosmic geometry, so that your experience of life is enhanced in such a way that what is you and what is cosmos in some way becomes a reflection of yourself, or you become a reflection of the cosmos, whichever way you want to see it. So because wherever we see an extreme sense of geometry, then we think yogis must have been here, because this level of geometry doesn't come unless you are into an internal process in ancient times. Now of course, people are studying geometry at a different level outside, but otherwise, at that time, the only way you could understand geometry so complex was studying your own structure, how this body is made, and observing the planets and astronomical phenomena. So at one time, yes, they controlled a few things, but I think all secret schools are overly exaggerated.
Triangle is the basic form in the existence in many ways. The most integrated form is a triangle. Before all this material came, like concrete and steel and all this stuff. Even now, I think in United States particularly, any home has a triangular roof, isn't it? In India, we've all gone for flat roofs because they use the concrete roofs and the weather permits a flat roof. So here still almost every house around has a triangular roof.
Yeah.
Why a triangle is, with minimum material, maximum strength, comes only from a triangle. If you have to create any other form of the same strength, you would need much more material. Material strength has to be increased. But in the form of a triangle, with very minimal material, you can get maximum strength. So always, anywhere in the world, if you give them two pieces of wood using earth as a base, you got a dwelling. So this is not just about the dwellings that you build. Even the divine hand, even the hand of the Creator, chose a triangle to build a basic form within you and outside of you. If you look at any molecular structure, it is a complex assembly of triangles in many ways.
Similarly, if you look at the human body in a different level, you will see there is something called as an energy body. The energy moves and operates in the body in a certain way. In yoga, there's a whole understanding and there is a certain way of experiencing how the energy functions in your system. If you look into this with awareness, if you see the way your system is constructed, you will see the most basic form in your body is a triangle.
All the nadis meet in the form of triangles. What we refer to as chakras are actually triangles. The nadis always meet in the form of triangles. We call them chakras because they symbolize movement. So that orange triangle with a circle around it is the Ajna chakra, which is the chakra of enlightenment and knowledge, knowing and perception. Because yoga is the science of perception. Yoga is the science of ultimate perception. So Isha Yoga uses the symbol of ultimate perception, orange triangle with a circle.
And if you have seen what are called as yantras in South India, there's lots of yantras, have you seen? The Sri Chakras and that kind of thing. Yantra means it's again an energy form. If you create certain forms, they have certain amount of energy, they can retain certain amount of energy. All the yantras are always built with triangles. They are a complex formation of triangles because that is the way the energy system of your body is built. That's the way in many ways the fundamental aspects of the existence has happened. That's why the triangle.
All right, so much different response than I was expecting. I thought that he was going to go into the, you know, the Illuminati and they're controlling the world and every, you know, the general ideas and commentaries about Illuminati, Freemason, all of that, and all these celebrities doing the triangle symbol with the all-seeing eye and everything. But no, not at all. Completely different. You know, this was another perspective and an angle that I've heard before, but not too many people are talking about it. But like the idea of what a secret school would be, you know, just because, yeah, if somebody does say something, hey, I found this, I found out that this can work, a new way to view life, a new way to live, a new way of building things, you know, and right away, if it goes against what is naturally there, like some of the bigger religions, it's like, even if they're not saying anything that's contradictory, you know, it's sometimes we have this idea that even if it looks a little bit off on the surface, we don't want it, right? So yeah, I think sometimes, yes, like all these secret societies and everything, they just get so overplayed and exaggerated that it may not necessarily be the case. And most people anyways that I hear talking about secret societies, Illuminati, Freemason, all that stuff, they literally have no idea. And all they're doing is just going off of what they found on the internet, some articles from people who absolutely have no idea. You know, if you want to learn, you got to actually go get in there. You got to read source material, talk to actual Masons, or join it and learn. And all that stuff, instead of creating conspiracy theories. Because that's the same thing with every religion. You know, I heard that about Islam. They said, oh, no, don't do that. Don't touch it. Don't go near it. You can get possessed by a demon if you read the Quran, you know, things like that. And to the point where I just said, no, I'm going to go do it. If the demon possesses me, I guess the demon possesses me. But I say that to say, regardless of what it is, it's always good to dive deep. And I think Sadhguru brought an interesting perspective that isn't quite talked about as much. And then he branched off into the triangles, like the power of the triangles and why it's used. It's such a basic shape, you know, even our bodies, the basic shape and structure is a triangle. Just look at how we stand, right? Various different things. So I could see how the triangle is so important, and the use of geometry, especially in the history of the Freemasons, you know, their symbol is a square and compass, right? Those are geometry tools that you use for constructing and building. So yeah, very interesting video, much different than I expected. Were you guys feeling the same too? Did you expect a completely different video, or you can kind of tell that it was gonna be going in this direction? Let me know down below. Also, if this is your first time here to the channel, go ahead and subscribe and ring the bell to be notified when new videos are posted. We post daily, so there's always something to watch here in FTD Speaks. I'll see you guys in the next one. Later.